Lunaria. Lunaria being a very strange champion. I don't know why she has magic damage. And there you go. Down they go. So that is the most free-to-play version of this I could find.
Fastidious.
Fastidious.
How the heck are you, everybody? My name is Fastidious. Welcome to my channel, and welcome to day 43 in our free-to-play series. So we are back in the brand new Wild Sands event that we have up here in the top right of your screen. We're going to do some stuff just exploring this, but mostly focusing on the Trials of Fury. This is active for 4 more days now, so a little less than 4 days. And this is where you get the big juicy rewards, right? So the rewards here are pretty substantial. You also have some really nice first time clearance rewards. I've already beat these two, but you can see here, guys, some really nice first time. Oh, there you go. You can see it there. Really juicy first time clearance rewards. I guess in total, you are going to get 7 shards plus a handful of diamonds and some of these unique rampage medals to use in the redeem shop. So when I first did this, I did it live on stream. We explored it. We tried C5 right away because they recommended that difficulty. And I kind of brought in my version of a god squad. My roster's not that good, but I brought in my best heroes and I cleared it like nothing. It was a total walk in the park. So I kind of dismissed it because I was thinking back, if you guys were playing during the Treasures in the Deep event, that was really hard for me. I still think I liked the gameplay of that event better so far, but it was challenging. But that might have also been because I think that event came around in like my second week playing the game. My roster was not nearly what it is now. So I think maybe I underrated the difficulty of this just because maybe we're a little overpowered. I will say I have a separate gripe I'm not gonna rant about, that I wish it could keep scaling up and up and up, so this would be challenging for me and then challenging for players way better than me still. However, I figured let's go in and try to make a free-to-play comp. I mean, all my comps, I guess, technically are free to play, but of course I've had lucky pulls here and there. So, you know, take out the arrogance, things like that, and let's see what we could do. So I figure I'm just going to do a little guide, a little walkthrough on that, and then we'll finish up. I'll just tell you a little bit more information I figured out about the total sign-in rewards. And finally, I will give my main impressions about the Redeem Shop and where I think you should be spending these fancy little Rampage tokens, the Rampage medals. Okay, but yeah, guys, the fight, if you're struggling with it and you're hearing other people saying it's so easy, it's so easy when you're using your best heroes and you've been playing for a month or two. It wasn't that easy. I actually really tried for over an hour to make a team with no legendaries work. And the only version of that I could do was with this guy right here, Deimos. And I came to the decision, I think it's more free-to-play friendly if I bring an Abomination. Let me know in the comments if you guys think I made the right decision, but I actually think Abomination might be more accessible than Deimos because you can fuse one epic and then pull 3 relatively easy to pull epics, at least anecdotally, whereas Deimos seems super, super rare, and also my Deimos is A5, so I thought this would be the most free-to-play version. I wish I had more epic fighters built out so I could have done this, but I came to the conclusion with this strategy I'm going to show you now, you really need 2 fighters, 2 solid fighters. So you see we're going to bring Wrath and we're going to bring Abomination, and that's how it's going to work. You can see, guys, I had Olog in here, I was able to take him out. I am going to bring Baron. You could bring whoever your best tank is, but then I very much suggest you go like this. Maybe you guys have seen me do this in other videos. Just go to Nightmare, and you can even bring this guy, Sorzus, or whoever you want, whoever you've got. You know, you can bring this level 1 Azor, it doesn't matter. Just someone to drop for a second to get that increased boost, because then you'll get the full effect of plus 35% attack speed. You know what? I actually will do that here just to demonstrate what this version of the team could do best. But Sorzus here, you can see he's going to have no gear. He's literally there just to drop a body. And even when you pick him up, that 35% attack speed and like the growth visually you've seen in the characters from the Nightmare faction will remain. So what's going on here, guys? Well, we're bringing some tanks. We've got 2 tanks here. Abomination's tanky enough that he doesn't need one behind him, so we were able to take out Olog. But in the center, we'll put Baron, and then we'll put, Livian behind Wrath. Then I got a couple piercers here just for some random damage. I'm bringing my girl Autumn in here to make this thing nice and smooth, get that crit rate buff, get that crit damage buff. She's awesome. I'm bringing 1 healer. That's going to be Vortex. You could totally do this with 2 healers, which maybe I'd suggest if you don't have a Vortex or a Holo. But it's pretty easy, especially if you had like an A5 Wrath, something like that, or an A5 Deimos. I guess it only has to be A1 Deimos. Then you could just have that guy self-sustaining, probably. But yeah, this is the version we're going to do. And then I'm bringing Imani. And actually, I realized when I was putting this together, I don't have Jankar, but I am actually showcasing 2 of the 10x champions right now, because we're bringing in Imani, and we're going to bring in Brienne. All right, enough of me talking. Let's get into this battle. I'm gonna start it on 1X just so I can explain as it goes, but it's a fairly straightforward fight. So basically, I want to take advantage of this top line and hit these units as soon as possible. So we're gonna drop Wrath there, and we're gonna drop Baron. This is where you can put your best tank. If you have Baron, he's really nice if you're gonna use this comp, because you can see plus 10% speed. He is gonna be our second unit from the Nightmare faction. And then soon, our next drop is gonna be Abomination, so we'll get our third unit. But we can throw this on 2x now. You can see I'm not going to use any cost regen. It might be scary because these guys walk down pretty fast, but the timer takes longer than you think, or at least longer than I thought originally. So we can get away just doing this. And now we're going to save up costs and just hang out. These guys are on auto ults. We can throw the ult on for Baron. It doesn't really matter. But we're going to get ready to drop our Vortex. So this is going to be our main healer. I guess also Autumn does later on in the fight kind of function as a healer, which is kind of nice. So we can just let this happen. Alrighty. And I'm going to show you the way I do it, guys. I'm already going to use Sorzus. So I'm going to watch this, guys. We're going to drop Sorzus. Maybe actually let me put it on 1x, because I found this out on stream yesterday. Not everyone knows this. So you can drop Sorzus. Now look, you're going to have plus 35%. Everyone got a little bigger. Pick him up. It remains. So all you have to do is just get that fourth deploy. So even if you had one Nightmare unit, you could just drop three if you want to take advantage of the bonus. But for us, we can just drop the one extra, and now they're going to be rocking and rolling. So the next thing we can do, guys, we're going to drop Lunaria. Surprisingly, or maybe not, I found she does a bit more damage on this stage than Brienne. But then we can drop Brienne right away next. And you can see these guys are all in Vortex's range. Nice and easy. And now we're just kind of cruising. I am going to drop Livian as soon as we can. Doesn't really matter right now. It's quite easy at the beginning, guys. Even with my all epics, when I made the team as bad as I could get towards the last, like this wave 4 and 5 pretty easily, but here it gets really hard. You're gonna see, I'll just show you the monsters really quickly. The two monsters of note are Baron, he's the big boss. He has heavy armor, so you're gonna probably want some kind of magic damage if you're struggling. And then these guys, the Pharaoh's Guard, these guys hit really hard and they come out a lot of them. So you're gonna have to really tank it and have multiple tanks, or you're gonna have to have some solid DPS. So for me, that solution was having the two ground fighters, Wrath and Abomination. But yeah, we've deployed everyone but one, guys. And I will also say we have these Whirlwindy guys. What do they call them? These sand takers, and they're gonna have this aura around them of like spinning sand, which is essentially dot damage. So you're gonna wanna pick those off as soon as possible. So you can see here, I've already saved up Brienne's ult. We can just trigger that and take them down real quick. Nice and easy. So here I just want to demonstrate something, guys. You do not have to use it, and you'll see we're sitting on a few units right now, but I'm just going to drop the best way to use Imani, and the reason you want to get her to A3 is because you want to drop her, and when her ult runs out, pick her back up, and then drop her, pick her back up. She's like a great redeploy unit, and at A3 her cost goes from 60 seconds of 60 cost, I don't know if it's seconds, but 60, it is seconds, right? 60 cost to 35 cost, so she's really easy to do this little cheesy thing with. So you can see here, we don't really need her, but I just want to demonstrate. So the way I recommend using Imani, mine isn't A3 yet, only A1, but you can see, clear it out, and now you can just pick her back up. She puts out a lot of burst damage really quickly, and her ult charges up. She's only 100 cost away, 100 rage cost away from her triggering her ult when you first deploy her. So you can just keep rinsing and repeating that. So now you can see I'm keeping that one extra redeploy ready. We don't need it yet. So this is the first harder wave. So I guess they're calling it wave 2, but this one we can just kind of tank. You can see we're doing pretty nice work of this. I'm gonna drop Autumn here very, very shortly. However, she's gonna be taking dot damage. She heals herself well enough, even though she heals herself quite poorly, that doesn't matter. However, I don't wanna drop her until I have to, just to make sure she stays alive for as long as possible. I'll also say, you'll see in the stats when I quickly go over the gear at the end, I won't show every character, I'll just quickly click through them so you guys can pause if you need, but Abomination is nearly at 100% crit, I believe. We're really just using Autumn for the extra 60% crit damage increase. So this is where it's gonna get hard, guys. So this is where we can start doing some clever stuff. So we can drop our Autumn right about now. The second these guys come in, we can trigger Brienne, because we wanna kill this row as soon as possible, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick up Livian so we can redeploy Imani now that she's ready. We can do some triggers here. Looks like she did a pretty good job. So what I'm gonna do, let's get her a couple more hits out. Okay, we can pick her up, and now I can drop Imani. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna 1x just so you can see. So now Imani's there, she's about to finish her ult charging. The second that's charged, then we can trigger Autumn and Imani. So this was the hard wave for me in my testing. So now we're getting Abomination with Autumn, and then Autumn with Imani. It's a lot of damage. We're gonna melt these guys, as you can see. And I got to leave Livian in. Oh, who did I pick up? Oh, looks like I picked up Brienne. Well, that works well too. Maybe that's what I did the first time as well. There you can see, it's actually kind of slight work. We took care of the Baron boss really, really easily. And that's kind of just on the shoulders of this magic damage we're getting from Imani and from, of course, Lunaria. Lunaria being a very strange champion. I don't know why she has magic damage. And there you go, down they go. So that is the most free-to-play version of this I could find. I tried not to put my absolute very best gear on all my champions, but you can see these are juicy rewards, and hopefully this helps at least one or two of you, if not more, get to C5, because getting these 30 diamonds, not a day, an attempt, and you get three attempts a day, so nearly 100 diamonds a day. It's 90 diamonds a day over the 5 days of this. I guess by the time you see this, you'll only have 4 days left. That's still 360 diamonds that you literally wouldn't get otherwise. Because to recap, it's not like you're getting less diamonds at C4. You're not getting any. So it's just kind of like you get this, and then you get one more thing, and then you get one more thing, and then you get one more thing, right? The rewards stack. So you really want to be at least, I would say, to phase four, but getting these diamonds at phase... Oh, excuse me. What was that? C5 rewards. Well, that was strange. Wait, hold on 1 second. C4 rewards. Oh, if you can clear his face. Oh, I had no idea. Wow, I'm so glad I caught that. Hopefully people haven't already lit me up in the comments. Does it work everywhere? Yeah, okay, I'm totally wrong. So those are phase completions. I thought those were stage completions. However, getting the max is better than not. However, it's not as vital as I thought. You're only getting 10 less energy, so 30 less energy a day, and 15 less diamonds a day. But come on, we want the max, baby. Let's do this. That's my little guide. I'll quickly throw together now my best team so you can see. Actually, first, let's go over the stats. So the key heroes, we don't have to show everyone in detail. We do have Abomination in a curse set. He's wearing very nice gear. So you can see very high attack, very high crit rate, and very nice crit damage. This is actually a crazy build. I probably should have made this build a little worse. I'm sorry about that, guys. Who else we got to show you here? Let's just scroll through. There's our Wrath. So you can see the Abomination Wrath have huge base stats. It makes it really easy to build them for content like this. You can see Broken Set and then a Whirlwind Set to get a little bit of attack speed on him. Here is our girl. That's just her weapon. Where's our girl Imani? There's Imani. I see, I actually left the amulet off Imani. So I guess I did a good job of keeping the stuff down. And then who else did we get? We got Brienne over here. There you have it. She's also in a curse set. I've started using curse sets a bit when you have these big mass mobs. It works out very nicely. So that's our Brienne, not the craziest build ever. Here's a Lunaria. So lots of mythic gear, but not everything's perfect. It's solid. It was harder to clear this than I thought, as I said. There's our Baron, 37,000 BP. You can see a healthy tank. He was our main tank. Here's our Livian. She's only 5 stars. She's doing her job. And finally, I think a lot of you that watch my content will be familiar with Autumn, but here is Autumn. All right, I'm gonna quickly throw my gear back on my actual heroes that I use, and then I'll show you how this fight goes when you bring your team to its ultimate strength. We swapped around some gear. Our A team should be ready to go. I just realized I forgot to show you Vortex from the first squad. He's gonna be on this one too. But you can see, pretty solid build. We've got a Salvation set, a Broken set. The one thing I'll say is the HP is a little low, but I'm certainly working on that. So let's get in here, guys. We've made a few changes. There's 5 new champions here, 4 new legendaries, 1 epic, who's surprisingly Ayn. He helps me a lot here. I'll just highlight him. He's in the same gear, basically, that Livian was just wearing, so just making him a little tanky. But I'm really just using him for 2 things. So he's got, where is it? Oh my god, where is it? Here, oh, sorry, it's his talent. Increases this hero and allies in front of him, they get penetration increase and damage increase. So we're gonna put him behind Wrath to make Wrath a little more potent. And I also do have Ayn Awaken 1, so he can also do some vulnerability physical damage. So if Volka doesn't get that on some of the units, maybe he can get on some of the units as well. So yeah, without further ado, let's hop on in. I do wanna say something. So we brought these 4 new legendaries, right? Nyx, Nocturne, Arrogance, and Volka. Look at this, Nocturne is not glowing. He doesn't have this weird effect that the other ones do. I really don't get what that's all about. It's just weird. Oh, now Arrogance isn't. What is going, this game's strange, man. It is strange. Let me know if you know what that's all about. So guys, slightly different setup in the beginning because we do have Arrogance and he can do a lot of stuff with this big old range. We'll plop him down first. We can really start putting out a ton of fighters and stuff. To start before Vortex, we can actually get all 4 of our Nightmare fighters down. Because we're not going to be taking damage, we're basically only going to be taking damage from the sand dot damage over time. Be a little bit more of other stuff as well. But yeah, we'll get Volca down and then we'll get Vortex down. And Volca actually, we'll probably see at the end, I think she's gonna do a surprising amount of damage. She's really solid. I've brought her into my XP raid stage 8 team. And guys, I only bring one AoE platform unit, and that's Nyx. And I've gotten up to 99%. I haven't been able to get to 100 yet, but I think that's more just my gear not being good. But these comps can work. These nightmare comps, especially with Volca, she doesn't just do debuffs and the heals. She's just legitimately solid. So you can see we definitely need Vortex. These two are getting low. And then I probably will already place Ayn behind Wrath. That should help him a good bit. And yeah, let me know in the comments or hit me up on my Discord or DM me, the Fast and Fastidious. I'm curious if this is something we need. Has anyone been struggling with this? Did you guys also find it really easy? Do you find it too easy? Do you wish there was more hard content? I'd be quite curious to hear. Was this the most unnecessary guide ever? I hope it helps at least one person. That would make it feel worth it. But yeah, I feel like there's this new content. We might as well do a little walkthrough, a little guide on the hardest level, right? So you can see we've got one deployable left. The plan here, guys, is we're gonna do Nocturne, and then we'll sit on Autumn till the end, and we'll just use Autumn with Volca and Abomination to try to burst down the Baron boss. Really mostly Volca, I guess. Actually, yeah, that's what we'll do. So yeah, you can see we haven't really needed too many ults. We're just kind of sit on this and save it as much till the end. Maybe I can get like my fastest clear time by having everything saved up for when Baron arrives. I feel like I'm stuttering in like every video now. Maybe I'm just talking too much. I don't know. We will trigger Nyx here just to be safe. Safe indeed, because we're not really going to need her AoE against Baron. But yeah, looking pretty good. Here comes Baron. I actually realize now that I'm thinking about it, I could have had everyone back a row, so we could have just trapped Baron right in there, but I think this might still be a faster run, we'll see. So guys, we get this first wave of these Pharaoh guards. They're a bit annoying, but you can see we're doing pretty nice work against them. I'm gonna save Nocturne, guys. Nocturne's ultimate will target the enemy. He has a passive that goes with it. They'll target the enemy with the highest defense. Obviously, that's gonna be this big boss Baron. You know what we can actually do? This is what we're gonna do. We can pick up Vortex here. I'll trigger his shield just to be 100% safe. Actually, I'm not gonna. Let's get Autumn down. We'll see if we even need her, but we'll do this. And then we can do a little bit of crit on a couple of these guys, including Arrogance, which should help a lot. Looks like he's gonna be dead before Autumn is ready to trigger. You can see it's a pretty breezy fight. We didn't need any tanks, nothing like that. I'll show you the stats really quickly. Also, sorry, I realized I forgot to show the stats with the first team. But yeah, I did get a new auto fight, so that's pretty cool. And there, these are some juicy, juicy rewards. So you can see Arrogance, he's a god. Then we also got Nyx doing some good work. What's nice for this is, like I said, I've been doing a lot of testing for XP raid stage 8, and I can use this is basically the exact same team, except for Ayn. I use Brienne instead of Ayn. Cool, there you go, guys. Let's hop into the other things I wanna touch on. Hopefully that was helpful. So the first most important thing, total sign-in. As you guys can see, we're like, not halfway, we're like a quarter of the way into the 15th day of these total sign-in things, and I have not claimed day 2, and by clicking in and out of it, I don't need to. So I think I can confirm for sure this day 6, if you saw my video earlier, the privilege card, you can hold off at least till day 12. And then the question is, day 12, does it automatically activate or will it go to your mail? I'm gonna guess it's gonna go to your mail, but I'm not gonna promise you that because I don't want people to assume it will work. But I think you guys, if anyone wants to test out and let me know in a few days or 2 weeks or whatever, I'd be really curious to see if this is gonna go to your mail and you can just save it for whenever you need it. Because then if these come back in the future, we'll know that that's the good strategy. I think that's what will happen, but I don't wanna promise you guys that and mess anyone up. But for sure, I think we can confirm you're not gonna need to claim this. You can probably claim them as you see fit. But I will claim this now, because why not? It's nothing to be gained or lost by waiting. And yeah, the last thing I wanna talk about is the redemption shop. So you see, you get these Rampage medals, and you can also get these from events that are live, so not related to this Trials thing and this Wild Sands and all that stuff. So I guess I can very quickly show you. Don't want this video to be too long. So anything that, here you go, the Brave Conquest, anything that isn't from the Lunaria event, there's some more from the Corridor. This Tales of the Smith you see is gonna have some. So yeah, what are you gonna spend those on? I thought we could have a very quick, I'm sure other creators will put out stuff about the shop. I'll just give my quick impressions. For me, it's like all about the skills and the summons. Energy is nice, blah, blah, blah. However, something to not be slept on, and this needs to be confirmed, but the second you buy these, I'm assuming they activate. These are the two best purchases in the shop. However, it's very unlikely you'll be able to buy them more than like twice. Maybe you can squeeze all three in actually, but this is as cheap as it's gonna get for XP bonuses and gold bonuses. So just to go right into it, that you should do very strategically, because now instead of only being able to farm gold once a week for 450 guild coins, you can save those guild coins if you want, or farm multiple times in a week, and you have three chances at this for only 30 rampage medals. You just saw that Tales of the Smith, I think, said it was giving 25 or 35 or something. So that's pretty sweet. You can also get these fabled dice to help you progress in this, where is it? The treasure hunt? Oh no, where's the thing? Oh my God. Why can't I find it? Oh, here it is, Odyssey of Dreams, duh. So you can see I'm almost done with the second map, I believe it is. We're almost halfway done with the second round of the first map. We're almost done with the first map. There's some juicy rewards in here for sure. But I would not buy these until the very end when you see, maybe you're gonna clear all four maps, no problem. Like right now we're clearing we're on pace to clear a map every 4 days. And it looks like this event, as you can see, is gonna go on for 15, 16 days. So maybe we could clear all of them without having to waste any of our stuff here. All this might do is expedite, which I'd rather save those potential 60 things. And then that's one more XP bonus, one more gold bonus, for example. So I would say these are probably the most important values in here, but do it very strategically. After that, obviously a very, very important thing, and we're all gonna buy it. It's one of one. Buy this legendary skill crystal. I would say don't buy the mythic extract. If you're really hurting for it, it's one thing, but can I click on this? You'll see, I've got 9. I just 6-starred champion. I feel like I'm always in excess. You get these from guild boss, unfortunately. Maybe fortunately, I don't know. But for me, I'm not gonna go for that. Legendary skill dust, pretty appealing, and then epic skill dust and epic skill crystals. If you have epics, you need to skill up. I wouldn't sleep on that, but I would say legendary skill crystal and the rare summons for sure. Then you can go for some of the skill dust as well. I would ignore this, obviously. Like, look, we have 49 of them that we need a solution to be able to, you know, fuse 10 or 20 of these into a mythic. This is useless. It's like the same kind of deal we have with the rare skill dust. I would definitely not go for the gold. I would definitely not go for the hero XP potions. Personally, I'm not gonna go for the auto fights. I mean, there's no value add, it's just convenient. But if convenience is what you value, that's one thing, but it's not a resource that's gonna directly benefit your account, unless for some reason you're only willing to do auto battles, but that's a style thing on you. But yeah, crystals for sure. So summoning crystals, skill crystals, I'm probably gonna grab this too. I know that we're gonna get tons of these as the game progresses, but right now I want my epic champion skilled up as soon as possible. But yeah, keep an eye on these. Try to find strategic ways. You're never gonna find a cheaper way to get these bonuses, and that's not time-gated because you'll get 3 of them. And yeah, I think that basically sums it all up. Definitely get this and definitely get these 6. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I've been Fastidious. Let me know if this video is helpful. I know it's not my exactly 100% normal kind of thing. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, like it. If you want to comment. Share it with your mom. I'll see you in the next one.
Fastidious.